Softr just released a highly anticipated new block for comments. Yes, you can now add comments directly inside of your Softr app so that people don't have any need to go outside of that environment to communicate and better collaborate on tasks, projects, whatever you have in your base. So if checking this out is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you save 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools. If that sounds a little too good to be true, well, it's probably because you haven't started leveraging the power of automation. So if you're interested in having automation perform those mundane tasks in the background, the best place to start is to check out my free training for no-code automation. You don't have to be a coder to know how to make this stuff work for you, and you can start saving massive amounts of time. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. We have to start by talking about the problem. Why are comments so important, and why is it super helpful that Softr put them together? Well, as you can see by dropping into my screen here, I've got a simple two-table database. I have tasks, and I've decided to connect to people in charge. Now, most of the time, we would probably add a collaborator field type if we were working internally in Airtable. But as you probably know, the whole reason that sometimes Airtable isn't sufficient for all of our problems is because we need to share limited access to people outside of our organization. And when we share an Airtable database, we share everything in that database with whoever we share it with. There's no way to limit or reduce what those people can see. So, in this particular case, I haven't used a collaborator field type. I'm imagining instead that we have a scenario where we've got a massive list of tasks. Of course, right now it's only three, but a massive list of tasks that we are going to share with a bunch of people. But when people log into our particular app, we don't want them to see everybody else's stuff. They just need to see their tasks. They just need to see that stuff that is important for them in the moment. So I've got a task ID. I've got a link to the person here. I have a date due, and I'm marking off whether it's complete or not. This is pretty straightforward for any kind of task management. Now, the next table over here is my person in charge. And this is where I actually have a linked relationship to Softr. In fact, I'm having Softr connect to this table for my users. So when new people sign up inside of Softr, then they will automatically be added to this person in charge table. I collect their email, their name, and Softr also allows for the use of avatars so that people can, when they leave comments, actually see that avatar at that moment in time. But in order for that to work, you have to have that avatar saved somewhere inside of Airtable. Now, in this case, I've also connected people to tasks. So I could set up a conditional filter inside of Softr that says when somebody logs in, whoever they are, they only see tasks that are assigned to them. And that's dictated by this person in charge relationship. Are they connected to that particular task or not? If not, you can't see it. But maybe, just maybe, there's somebody, some admin, some management level in your operation that sees all the tasks and they can respond to comments as they come in. And that's what we're gonna imagine we have in this particular scenario. So to get started flipping into Softr, I need at a minimum two different pages. Now the first one of these pages is going to be a list block, and this is where I list out all the different tasks, and I don't drill into detail on them. Instead, I set up this list block. In this case, all I'm bringing in is the ID and the person in charge, and this is the important part. On click, the action that has to happen is we open a page. What page? Well, that's the detail page. That's the second page that we need to build. And this is where on our detail page, we create a second page here. On the detail page, we start with a list detail block. And this is where we can drill down a little bit deeper into not all of the different tasks, but the specific task that was selected. So when somebody looks at the total list on the first page of our app, they make a selection and they drill down into more nuanced detail. So that's what this is. This is a list details block. We have to have this element in order for comments to work because the comments are going to be assigned to a particular record inside of Airtable. And that record is one record within that list of tasks. So we have to start with that list details block as we've shown here. Now again, for me, I'm keeping this really high level. I'm just including the name of the task, the date due, and the person in charge. Really straightforward, but you could customize more in your list detail block if you'd like. But the fun part, and what we're here to discuss, is the comments block. How does this work? We plop in a comments block, and we have the option of connecting it, syncing those comments to Airtable. And this is going to happen in a third table if we so choose, but I haven't done that yet. I'm starting off with just the bare basics of this. We have a few options here. How many items do we want to show by default on the comments here? You can see that there are three examples and then a see more. So you can choose to show fewer or more comments as you like. You get a title here, subtitle. You can bring in the user avatar and give it some customization in terms of border and all of that if you'd like. But this way we can see who's leaving those comments. We have the username, we have the date that they left the comment, and of course, most importantly, the comment itself. You also have the ability to change what happens if there are no comments. In this case, we'll simply get a message that says no comments, or we can change the text on the label here. So this is the see more button. If you have more comments than are currently showing up on the page, what do you want that button to say? Little bit of customization. Just like Softr, I like it. I get to make it look and feel the way I want to, but let's publish this app and see what it looks like. Now let's go ahead and open up this app, but I need to caution you that you must first be logged in as a particular user. If you haven't logged in as a user, Softr isn't going to allow you to put in new comments because it doesn't know who you are, so you have to be a logged in user. In order to get that functionality, you first have to make sure to connect your user's table to Softr and make sure that you've logged in as someone in particular. Now, I've created a magic link for myself, so I can go ahead and copy this link, and I can use this link without needing to sign in as a user so that when I'm logged in, this is what I'm gonna see. So what happens? I can make a selection here. Let's say I wanna record a video. This is my task. When I drill into it, I see all this information. And as you can see, I've left some comments previously. I can make a new comment here and go ahead and leave that comment, and instantly it's gonna show up here. Now, because of the fact that I added my avatar after having created these comments, you see that it doesn't get pulled in for these, but now my avatar is showing up. But it knew who I was, grabbed my avatar, and also captured the date time in my local time zone, I should point out. This is 13:26 or 1:30 roughly, my local time. And I think that's a great feature because seeing it in Greenwich Mean Time, for me at least, isn't very helpful. I don't want to do the mental gymnastics to figure out what that is in my local time. So it looks like these comments are going to come in based on the local time zone of my browser, which is fantastic. Now, for the last piece of this, if we really want to kick this up to the next level, I'm going to try out those more advanced adding comments, syncing that to my Airtable. So I can connect to Airtable here. Now that it knows I want to sync, it's going to ask me what base I want to sync with. So I can make that selection here. Let's say Softr, here it is, task example for Softr. And it's going to ask me what table in that base I'm looking for. Now I haven't built that table yet. So you'll notice that these are the different fields I'm going to have to map to. Who's the commenter? What's the current record? What's the comment field, and what's the created date? So let's go ahead and create that new table, and I will call it comment records. Create an empty table, comment records. And we need to bring in or create fields for those different elements. So if we want to delete our existing fields, we can flip back into Softr and remind ourselves, I need the commenter ID. Let's go ahead and create that exactly. Commenter ID. And this should work as a linked relationship to the person who's creating this. So I'm going to get a link from my comment records to the person who left that record. Only one person can leave a comment, so I'll create the field. Back into Softr, I've got current record as my next one. So current record. And I will again here link to the task, because remember, it's the task record that we're leaving a comment on. A comment can only be applied to one task, so make sure to toggle that off and create that field. Next, I'm going back for the comment itself and the created date. So flipping back into Airtable now, let's make the comment actually the name of the record, and I'll make this a long text field, and the last field will be that created date. And don't get confused here, we don't want to actually use the created time because this will timestamp, this is metadata, and I believe that Softr is actually going to pass the right date in at the time that that's created. So instead we're going to want to make this just a standard date field that includes time. Let's test that out at least. We might have to go back and make some changes. Now, flipping back into Softr, we can map to those things, but before I do, I need to refresh. So I will refresh that connection to this database and now tell it that yes, I've built a new table. It's called comment records, and we should be able to map to these things. The commenter ID, the record should be the link to tasks, which we have called current record. The comment field itself is called comment. And lastly, the created date is called created date. So looks like we got all of that properly synced up. Let's go ahead and publish and see how this plays out. Now, remember, I'm already logged in as myself in this app. So let's go ahead and refresh our page so that we get a clean new sheet of ice. And here I am again in that record video task. I'm going to leave a new comment here. And let's go ahead and slap that in. And when I do, we see that, yes, I got the new avatar, got the comment timestamped, I got the comment itself. But did the comment get recorded back in Airtable? It sure did. I now see the comment itself in that long text field. I have the commenter, in this case me, the person logged in. I have the record that I left it on. Remember, the record was record video, and I also get that created date. We can take this out for yet another test if we want to back up from our app and go back to all the different tasks. And now I'll leave a comment on Hail Airtable and Softr, and these comments are amazing, in all caps. And let's drop that in. As soon as that happens, remember, this is the record that we're leaving that on. Hail Airtable and Softr. If I go back to my database, I see that it was properly linked here. A new comment record was left by this person, left on this record, and timestamped appropriately for when the record was created. I know that we went fast here and there's a lot to unpack. The short version is you can store comments right in your Softr app. And if you want to really kick things up to the next level, you can also add those comments back into your Airtable database. This new block is pretty game changing, if I do say so. I hope you get a chance to check it out. If you want to stay on top of no code tools, be sure to subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon. Thank you.